Where should I start? Can you guide me? What resources can you recommend me? I get this asked a lot. TLDR, I don't know. I genuinely don't know. Before I tell you my thoughts, I have to mention that I'm young. I have very limited exposure to the industry. I have not had different jobs in this field, and so I really don't know how to transition from another job into it, what certifications to get, how to balance a full-time job and a family, anything country specific. I really can't help you with that because I have zero experience. All I can look at is my life and tell you my thoughts about it. If you disagree with what I will say or it doesn't help you, then you need to ask somebody else. I don't have the answer. But I think there are a lot of misconceptions about how to get into the security field, and I try to explain now why. Maybe you think there is some kind of shortcut, or at least a very efficient path. You hope a professional or experienced person can easily tell you about a clear path to success. I certainly had exactly those thoughts several years ago. I got frustrated why nobody would write down a clear guide. I felt somewhat entitled that I have a good experience already, I just need some guidance or mentoring. But the truth is, there is no efficient path. Truth is, it just takes years of experience. So if you think that somehow it would be easier with a study plan, it's not, so forget it. I'm sure you know this interview question. What advice would you give your younger self? And for me, I don't know. While certainly thinking differently at the time, in retrospect, I don't think there was anything bad or inefficient about the path I took. Of course, I could help my younger self understand certain concepts better and faster, and that's what I try to do with the videos. The videos cover exactly what I would tell my past self, but I couldn't lay out a path of do X, Y, and then Z. There is no secret step-by-step guide. It's not a straight path, but a web of interconnected topics, layers, and dependencies, and you're free to walk and jump between stuff however you want. Truth is, anything you do, any tutorial you follow, any project you start and never finish, any dead end you head down, it's not wasted. It's all experience that is accumulating over time. If I learned anything about hacking, what it means, what it is, then, at least to me, it's not really something I can get a hold on. It's an abstract, artistic, and broad term for many different things. Truth is, hacking is just learning IT stuff, but kinda in an artistic, weird, creative way. Maybe now you say, well, tell us about your path then. Clearly it got me somewhere, right? Maybe that's the ultimate guide. Well, there are a few things I can mention. My path is also full of just luck. Opportunities I have never planned for, so it's also somewhat not applicable to anybody else. Nevertheless, here are a few checkpoints that maybe give you some idea. As a kid, I started with some HTML. Then I got a book about Visual Basic Script and I wanted to write an operating system in it. If you have ever written Visual Basic Script, it's a bit like JavaScript, you know how ridiculous that idea was. But that didn't hold me back. I asked this question in a forum and was called a dumb troll. I was really sad that day, because I was just a kid trying to learn something and I had no idea what it means to have an OS. Anyway, at some point I got into web programming with PHP, so I had to learn actual HTML, CSS, JavaScript, PHP and MySQL. I started and abandoned several browser game projects. Then I heard about SQL injections and I did a school project on it. Here I wrote a test application and explained how injections work. I started to learn Java and got into Android app programming, did some C++ and a bit of game programming, made a shitty Monopoly clone. Then I did some Google Wave gadgets. Does anybody remember that? I was just a dumb kid and my code was ugly, but my pull gadget got some attention from a professional, that was cool. I learned more about computer science fundamentals in university, data structures and algorithms, learned about Linux because I started to use it at work. Joined the hackerspace and learned about Arduinos and soldering. And then I guess the major turning point, I discovered my first CTF, the Stripe CTF, and got hooked on war games and other challenge sites. And essentially here I am now. And now I'm a freelancer doing security, code audits, pen testing, application security and that kind of stuff. And please don't ask me how to get into freelancing. I have no clue how to do it. I met a guy who knew a guy who recommended me and here I am. So that was not planned at all. And looking at my history, imagine that these are just large checkpoints. It's not a straight path. It's traversing through a jungle of different topic. It's kind of like a fractal or the coastline paradox. If you zoom in, you uncover even more complex lines. There's a lot of stuff I did not mention in this high-level view, like making RPG Maker games where I was first exposed to if-else logic blocks, or modding my calculator with a window and LEDs, one of my first exposures to electronics. And if you ask me where to start, where should I point you to? Is the start the first HTML line wrote as a young kid, or is the start when I had already years of programming experience and discovered CTFs? I have no answer for you, you have to figure that out yourself. But one truth is, I didn't discover any secrets. There is no anonymous secret hacker organization with forbidden knowledge. I simply apply the knowledge that I gained about computers over the years. You know, programmers use the same knowledge but just think differently. They think, how can I make it work? And a hacker thinks, how should you implement it so that it's secure, and what could a lazy programmer do wrong? Truth is, the more you understand how something is built, you can also think about how it could break. So I'd say 95% of what I'm doing is just learning about how computers work. And by that I mean learning a ton of different programming languages, frameworks, concepts, and so forth. Over the years, I gained a very good broad basic understanding from low-level logic gates over simple circuits to PCBs and chips, microcontrollers, low-level programming, assembler, C, firmware, operating systems, higher-level languages, language and programming concepts, data structures, file structures, 3D programming, networking, cryptography, servers, server administration, websites, frameworks, databases, web apps, mobile apps, math, machine learning. The list is endless. And you see, nothing on this list screams hacking or security, because this knowledge is just the base requirement, the tool that I use to do my job as a professional hacker. Like I said, it's not secret knowledge. It's everything a programmer, sysadmin, or whoever would learn, just applied a bit differently. So I'm thinking, what could go wrong? How can files be exposed? How could I gain access without a password? How could I modify something that shouldn't be modifiable? How can I manipulate the output, and so forth. And maybe it's surprising to you, but that's not different from what a programmer or IT architect would do. They use the exact same technology, just have different thinking patterns, different problems they try to solve. So they think, how could I use these things to build a social network? How could I build a time-lapse camera? How could I make a fun game? Different problems, different goals, but based on the same knowledge. And the security-focused stuff like conference talks, CTF write-ups, trainings, academic papers, blog posts are essentially just sharing cool ideas how to apply this knowledge in a security-focused way. And that is not different to a programmer sharing techniques on how to handle huge datasets efficiently or how to implement a game AI. Don't think of hacking as anything crazy or special. It is based on exactly the same thing, just with a different angle. Breaking, not building. So to summarize, hacking requires a lot of knowledge about computers, and I say generic computers because it could literally mean anything IT related. And learning a wide variety of technologies and gaining experience and knowledge to draw from just takes time, it takes years. So any game you develop, any Minecraft redstone circuits you build, any boring sorting algorithm, any math class, any mobile app you start and abandon, anything you do is knowledge you accumulate and eventually can use. So one general advice I give is, it takes a lot of time, so make sure you have fun. Enjoy learning about computers. Enjoy programming. Enjoy following tutorials. Enjoy learning a new language. Whatever it is that you have fun with, it will keep you motivated over the years. Don't get me wrong, you don't have to first program for years and then get into security. You can do it in parallel. When you write an Android app, look into the official Android security tips. Think about what could go wrong, what happens if you don't follow it. Play around with it. And maybe at some point you want to build a web API to be used by the app, and suddenly you learn web development and server administration. Then you have to debug your connection and how that can be used to analyze and test stuff. This is essentially the process you will be doing for the next few years, and that's what I do all the time. You know, the thought of being able to hack an iPhone or gaming console or banking terminal is motivating, but good chance is that you are just very, very far away from that. I'm at least not there yet. I failed my Nintendo Switch hack attempt. I barely understood the surface. But that's fine. I keep learning, and I have a ton of fun with learning basics and learning a new programming language and learning new technologies. And in a few years, in two more console generations, maybe I know enough to join one of those teams. I know you might still feel frustrated where to start, but if you feel frustrated, then that's probably because you picked a target way too large for you. If you don't know the steps you need to take, it's too far away to see how to get there. So try to break that goal up. For example, if you want to get into bug bounties and you have no clue how to do that, analyze it. Sit down and try to uncover the underlying topics. For example, bug bounties are usually web security. Web security means hacking websites. Websites can be written in a ton of different languages. So start with one. Learn PHP. Learn what can go wrong with PHP. Learn about different PHP frameworks. Learn about different databases. And with learn about, I mean write your own websites. Use the frameworks. Just play around with it and gain experience. When you get bored with PHP, look into Python. Learn about Python Flask and Django. What can go wrong with Python websites? What can go wrong with Ruby websites? Do you see how the typical Ruby, Python, and PHP web security issues are super different because they are different languages? Learn about JavaScript, learn about HTML, and try to understand what XSS means. You see how that single topic just immediately exploded in so many subcategories, and there you have a list of stuff you can spend years on. And it's not a step-by-step path, it's a collection of topics, and you basically jump around between them and slowly understand them deeper and deeper. Over the years, I've revisited the security of PHP websites and I always learn a bit more. You can go even so deep to look into the actual PHP source code. So this is what you have to do. Break it up, try to understand the layers that build up whatever you want to do and learn these layers. It's a bit of research, but that's part of it. And another thing I want to make clear, you won't find these things when searching for hacking tutorials. That's something I had to learn. Truth is, most resources hackers use are regular documentations and programming resources. Hacking tutorials like what I show you in videos is just showing you how to apply that stuff to security. You don't need to rely on me or any other person to write it up for you. You can do it yourself. In many videos, I'm not referencing any secret hacking book. I just simply open the official AVR assembler reference, or look into the PHP function documentation, or look at the official Linux manual pages. So, let me summarize. No, there is no clear, easy path to learn this stuff, and I can't help you. There is no secret book or website to learn it. The more you understand computers, the more ideas and understanding you have what can go wrong. Programming, abstract theory, and so forth is important to understand computers. And just have fun. If making games sounds fun, make games. It takes years to accumulate this knowledge, so make sure you enjoy the ride. And one last thing I want to say. I make the videos in a way I would have loved to watch them years ago, which means I already had experience with programming. So I guess my channel is not intended for complete programming beginners. But I still hope that what I just described helps you to get somewhat started. And if you have some experience, just keep watching my videos and take some inspiration to look deeper or into different topics. You absolutely don't have to understand everything, but catching one thought or seeing one tool I use can be all the difference. And I hope the videos at least give you a rough idea how stuff works and you can research it once you actually need it. If you want some more guidance, you can also check out my playlists. I have a fairly long binary exploitation playlist, mostly based on exploitexercises.com. But I also have some web security videos, or just my CTF write-ups. Like I said, it's not a clear path, so just keep jumping between topics and just have fun. Look into stuff, get frustrated, and then look into other stuff. And otherwise, maybe look at Over the Wire, Pico CTF, ctftime.org, try out some bug bounties, or just look at other programming YouTube channels and learn about something new. Maybe make sure to check the description for links to stuff I recommend. Anyway, always try to learn something new. And trust me, if you just stay curious and keep looking into many different new things, in a few years, you will totally get there. Be patient.